into a 5-4 run. I mean, Junior Pens, they gave us a heck of a series. Can't say enough about it.
No, absolutely. We saw a back and forth from Junior Pens and Jose, where it looked like Pens was going to run away with game two. Jose battles all the way back for only to have Pens carry on the win and force a game three where he was not able to get it done, meaning that Jose is going to be one of our finalists for the North American Console Championship. He is going to be joined by DunkinDeli, as he was able to take out Sauceshow in one of the more spirited matchups we've seen. A lot of fun in the background, especially in Sauceshow, while his roommate was trying to just do his homework. Deli had a hand warmer out. There was chirping. It was great. It's what you want to see at the highest level of Chell. And I'm excited to see what's on tap today. Remember that all of this is going to culminate in heading to the North American Championship on May 20th in Washington, D.C. And the last two seats, they are going to be filled today. It's the same situation as yesterday. If you lose the semifinal today, you are out. Now, we got to meet our four players that are going to be playing today in our two semifinal matchups. So let's take a look. Our first matchup will be between Focus TF, representing the Arizona Coyotes. He got here through the online open play and knocked out Polgs, who was among the four players of the All-Star Open along the way. He was actually able to take down Nip and Biscuits, who had just had that upset prior to that. So an impressive run there. He's going to be going up against Cadcooks, and I refuse to call him Cadcooks during this. Yeah. I have known him since he was, I think, 17 years old, coming up in the community. It is Cad. All right? We are going to call him Cad, representing the Chicago Blackhawks. He got here from winning the Blackhawks Club Championship, and he will be representing them. He knocked out Gren on his way here, winning 2-1 in their best of three, and we're going to get into that as well, because just like we mentioned yesterday, there is not a lot of returning players to this stage of the tournament, so huge storylines there. The second semifinal is personally my favorite to watch and the most interesting one after covering NHL esports for the last 5 to 6 years. Boily and Sky is taken are among the two best players that we have in the game. We've seen Boily a little bit more. He was able to qualify for the stadium series in Rally, where he did come up short in the finals there. But Sky is taken is one of the best players that we have seen in Hockey Ultimate Team over the last couple years, but he has never been able to get it done when the lights shine the brightest. However, he is firing on all cylinders this year, and we're gonna see as he represents the Philadelphia Flyers, Boily representing his Montreal Canadiens. So Grizz, which two players do you see making it through today and qualifying for the North American Championships?
Well, the Boily Sky series is so tough for me. Like you said, it is two of the better players, and they both defeated really good players to get to this point. I mean, Sky had to go through Aves, he had to go through Dodzy, and he went through AK. So that's a pretty tough run. On the other side for Boily, well, he was able to take out Hendry as well as Ethan C and Dats. So another good run over there. I'm going to go with Boily. I think Boily has a little more poise given that LAN experience that he does have now. And in our other series, I'm sorry, Focus, but I got to go with Cad. I think Cad is one of the best. We saw what he was able to do against Gren. The thing with Cad is consistency. Can he stay consistent? Can he stay at that level that we know he's able to provide? If he can do that, he should be able to take care of business here today.
I agree. I think that as long as he doesn't get down, we've seen him kind of have the wheels fall off when he gets some unexpected goals scored against him. Definitely in the IHF tournament. But nonetheless, he is, like you mentioned, one of the best players that we have, especially when you consider the fact that the prior champions, Gren, Rags, no Polgs, those players aren't here. So there is a lot to be available to be taken here. There's a lot of opportunity. All right. And we are going to find out very shortly. But we've got to hear just quick word from our sponsors before it is time to meet our first two players in our first semifinal. We'll be right back. Thank you. right, welcome back, everybody. My favorite portion of these broadcasts. It is time to properly meet our first two competitors. Let's take a look at Cad, Cooks, and Focus.
My name is Samuel Landry. I'm 21 years old, and my gamer tag is Cadcooks. I actually don't have a celebration.
Let's go!
I try and stay super calm. I don't cook in real life, but I do cook on NHL on right wing.
We lead baguettes.
To all my doubters, I hope you have fun watching my games on your couch.
My name is Christian. I am 22 years old. And my gamer tag is FocusTF. Didn't expect it to make this far. I think a lot of people didn't expect me to either. Being one of the only players to favor the defensive side definitely will give me an advantage, especially against someone like Cad, who has a fast-paced offense. To the doubters, I'm sitting here and you're not. Simple as that.
All right, there was a couple things. There was a very, very similar tone to both of those. You're sitting here and I'm not. So, I mean, like, that was, you know, it's good for them to prove the haters. I think that you definitely mentioned Cad going into this, probably the favorite, but Focus was able to survive. And I think that's kind of a theme in NHL 23. You've got to be able to beat opponent, obviously, in a single elimination best of three. But you've got to survive. So there is something to that. So going into this matchup, what's the thing that you think Focus needs to do specifically to beat Cad?
Get ahead early. If you get ahead early, like I said, Cad typically doesn't play well once he's down in a game. But on the other hand, going back to the Gren series, I mean, that was like punch after punch. I know you were tuned into that game as well. It's like every time one guy scored, the other guy came back and scored right away too. I think they had a 7-6 game, something like that, which is just insane. But for Cad, like, we've seen him play very good, among the best in the game. We've also seen him be very, very bad at times. And which one are you going to get? It can be a coin flip. So it's the mental edge, I think, that Focus will have in this game. Maybe a little more consistent. Maybe not as high of a level overall, but get that first goal. Maybe score a cheesy one and get Cad rattled, and we'll see what happens.
Well, if he doesn't win the tournament, and he needs to go into radio or broadcasting, he's got a voice that is perfect for radio.
Oh, yeah.
So I don't know. Maybe when we speak to him, I got to let him know, because I feel like he needs to narrate like an audiobook or something. So we'll find out what happens as we're just waiting to see if we can get them on the line to talk to them before they go into their first round matchup. I think you kind of touched on it. I think for Focus to win, if you get to this stage of the tournament, you're good no matter what. Like, there's no way you can say one player is better than another. That's fine. And maybe if you played 10 games, the other one might win 8. That being said, if you got this far, you were good. You are capable in the way that NHL 23 is played. You know, you never know. All right. So we'll see if Focus can. I think for Focus, I think if he wins game one, I think he's got to win game one. But let's bring on Focus. And there he is. Hello. Can you hear me?
What's up?
All right. Okay. So you haven't made it this far in the tournament, my man. How are the vibes? Are you nervous? Are you locked in? Are you more serious than you normally be? Tell me, how are you doing?
I think if you talk to a lot of friends that I have, I'm always a serious guy. I feel like I've had a lot going on the past couple weeks. I just finished university, so shout out UW.
Let's go.
I know Always also a UW graduate, so shout out esports at UW, even though there's not any action going on. But yeah, it's been busy. I'm always serious. There's always a little bit of nerves too going into big games. I think Nip in there was as well. Going down in the first game and then coming back, beat him twice, and he wasn't too happy about that either. So I just gotta sometimes
he was not
in the seriousness. No, he was not. He had some choice words for me as well, and he didn't want to hop on to discuss. So, you know, characters of the community, I say.
So, my man, not to give too much away here, but obviously me and you go way back in LG S31, Brandon Wheat Kings. We had that Big Tipper connection before Big Tipper was in the game. You know how to get those shots? Are we going to see any Big Tipper goals here today?
My name is not Junior Pens 91. I do not do that stuff. I'm gonna tell you that right now.
There we go.
I find that it's very like luck of the draw type style of play. If anybody knows how I play, I like to do a lot of counter. And I know Cad also likes to rush as well. So I don't know. We'll see what's in store.
Well, my man, you are almost all ready to go for game number one. I got to know in the background there, there's like some conflicting things going on in terms of the jersey selection. So how pumped were you last night as I see the two Toronto jerseys in the background?
Yeah, so Toronto's my main team. Obviously, I was pumped watching that. I was a little bit under the weather because I went and saw a Fisher concert on Monday, downtown Toronto. So happy I could come back to catch that. But I got a McDavid jersey to the right, as you can see in the mirror. Other side. Favorite player, just overall, I guess, besides Sundin. And then the one above my head is the one I got from a couple years back in the Anaheim Ducks Club Championship. And then there's a Drysdale one and a Bayern Munich one as well. So there's quite a bit of jerseys. I'm just a sports fanatic all around, I say.
Hey, where's the Bills jersey?
No Bills jersey. I know. I'm actually like torn between Trey White, Kyrie Elam, and a James Cook jersey as my first. I feel like Josh Allen's
James Cook
stereotypical first choice.
Yeah.
Well, my man, I want to thank you. Good luck in your matchup. I can't wait to see how it goes. And let's bring on Cad. Let's bring on his opponent. There he is, my man Cad. All right, he's cooking. The chef, some may say. All right, I got to know. Who is going to be your most impactful player on your squad today?
I'd probably say McDavid, just because the way I play with gold elite edges, and like I play super fast and I use the speed, so I would say McDavid or McKinnon probably.
So I would say that you are not the underdog in this matchup. How do you feel going into a matchup where you might be favored?
I just take, I don't know. I don't really care about this. I just like play my game and I play whoever and hopefully I can win. But I know Focus is a good player, so I'm not going to underestimate him.
Are you winning in two or three?
I want to win in two, obviously, but... I don't know. We'll
see. Confidence, fellas. I'm trying to get the confidence out of you guys. And you're all, no one wants to be like, except for DunkinDeli. He's the only one.
Yeah.
Two or three, Cooks.
I'll say two. Just for
all
you.
Right, there it is. All right. You've got a big game going up against Focus. Go get ready for that. Thank you for hopping on to discuss. Grizz, let's get a little bit more info on our players. Let's walk us through the player profiles for Focus and Cad.
Yeah, so let's take a look at our first player. We do have Christian, otherwise known as Focus the Fug. That is what the TF stands for. To age 22 from Toronto. He mentioned it earlier, his favorite player, Matt Sundin. And a little bit to know about Focus. Like I said, he's been around for a while. He's not really gotten to this stage. And I think today he can really make a statement. Obviously, he did have a good run to get here. Mentioned some of the players that he beat earlier. But, I mean, for Christian, he's got a very good opportunity ahead of himself right here, and we'll see if he can get it done.
Excellent. And what about his opponent, Canadians? Just fold me.
So, with Cad, one of... Canadians 27, you might know him by, Samuel Landry, age 21, from Montreal. Favorite player, Alex Ovechkin, not Cole Caulfield. That's kind of surprising to me. Anyway, for Cad, one of his strengths, he is so creative offensively. He was able to defeat Gren and really just out-battle Gren. And we've seen what Gren was able to do. So definitely one of his strengths, the way he's able to attack. And if he's going to win this tournament, he's going to spend the money on it to put on a down payment on a house.
Respect there, absolutely, for Samuel. Well, we are almost ready to go in our first game, everyone. We will be right back with a word from our sponsor with game number one of our first semifinal between Cad and Focus.
At Great Clips, we use Clip Notes to save NHL player Cale Makar's haircut details, so he's always confident in his hockey hair. Because with a name like Kale, you gotta sport great salad. Great Clips, official hair salon of the NHL.
We're about to jump into game number one between Focus and Cad. And you mentioned it going into this. Cad, one of the best in terms of the half spins. He's extremely good with the LT. And he even mentioned it as why Connor McDavid was his favorite card that he will be using, simply because he's just one of the most agile. He uses elite edges a lot. And we'll see if Focus can handle that. I think that as long as he doesn't pressure defensively, you know, comes back with him and just make sure that those spins don't get out of control, I think he has a shot. But we are gonna find out regardless. Semifinal number one, game number one of today. It's Focus and Cad, and we are underway in the first period. We've got Focus in the Arizona Coyotes oranges. Those are some great unis. Going up against Cad in the whites. Here's McKinnon. Focus has got it with Connor McDavid. Just moving on to the second round. I apologize, Carlin. As here comes Cad, down low near the goal line, bumped off the puck. Focus again here, making sure that he doesn't overcommit, but Cad walks right in, and it's the backhand forehand with Dobson, and it's 1-0.
You mentioned it, Cam. The half spins, he's so good at that, but it's not just the half spins. The way he's able to protect the puck and allow Focus to commit out of position, and he just drives it in towards the net. A little short side cheese there. 1-0 Cad early.
The chef appears to be cooking, as that's just, I can't get over it. Cad cooks. As here is Cad looking for more. McKinnon down behind the net. Wrap attempt, maybe. It's going to be sent out in front now. Focus gets absolutely crushed in the neutral zone on that breakout. Back into his own zone. As there's Cad backing in with McKinnon. Looking for more. A good stick defensively. Focus did mention that he plays very defensive. And that might help him in this matchup against one of the better offensive players remaining in the tournament. Medano now streaks through the neutral zone. He's across the blue line. Stutter step at the top. Now Boldy walks into Medano. Medano in the high slot. Walks to the left side. He hits Forsberg down low. They give and go. Cad puts some pressure on. Pressured there, but Medano's going to come away with it. Focus looking to tie things up. 7 minutes into the first period. As Boldy misses that one. Nurse and some pressure there. And it's going to be Cad. He's in. One-on-one. Backs in on the back end. Waits for some support. No shot there. And again, we see those spin moves early and often from Cad now on the back end. Focus trying to make sure that that backside shot is covered, as now he walks out. Pasternak's going to rip one on, and that one is going to be stopped. Now Focus with Boldy. He spins himself across the blue line, sends it down low, but Kucherov will be on the intercept. Now Tavares across the line. Good Pocheck there. He had a big game for his Leafs last night. Now McDavid in. He's in tight, tries to go with the short side upstairs. That's not going to go, and it remains 1-0.
Well, you're seeing a good counterattack from Focus here, but Cad doing a good job thus far maintaining that 1-0 lead. And Cad, it looked like he was going to have a chance 1-on-0, but Focus able to regroup.
As at the top, here's Focus to Yossi. Yossi down to Matthews. It's knocked free, and Ovechkin breaks it out for Cad. Up 1-0. It is now Ovechkin. Pressured there. He's got unstoppable force, so he's going to be an absolute load to deal with. Focus, a bad turnover on the breakout there, and Cad's got possession one more time. Focus has really got to make sure that he holds onto the puck as much as possible, because a wrap attempt right there from Cad. That one doesn't go. Second time we've seen an attempt there. But like I was mentioning, it's just going to be so hard to get the puck back from Cad. So he's got to play defense by offense, essentially, if he's going to have some successes. Now Larkin off the bench. This Slavkovsky. Nice mix of players here for Focus. Larkin down low, looking to tie things up. Waits for some pressure, sends it across, but Guerin isn't there. A weak shot from the point. And Slavkovsky now to Guerin. Guerin still holding on. He's going to get knocked free, but an absolute huge hit there on McDavid towards that breakout attempt. Across the line, he's got it. Here's Focus to Larkin. That one gets knocked free. Dobson on the breakout sends that to Ovechkin. Only 3 minutes remaining in the first, Grizz. This has been an extremely quick first period.
Yeah, and they both love that counterattack ability, like I mentioned. They're not going to go off sides a whole ton. There's not a lot of stoppages to play in this period whatsoever. These guys are just going back and forth.
Here's Petrangelo. He'll reset in the neutral zone. Up to Eric Daze, the 98 team builder. Go to Lindholm now. Lindholm's going to try to break it in. He gets crushed there at the blue line by Eichel. And now Eichel on the breakout. Dre lines in, has a shot. No pass in the middle there. Thought we'd see one. That one's going to be thrown into a mass of bodies. Doesn't make it through the net. 5 seconds remaining in the first. A shot attempt there. One more from Eichel, and he scores. 2.2 remaining. And that's a huge goal for Cad.
All right, so Cad with the possession down low works it back across. And that far side shot finds its way home as Cad was left open in the slot. Not going to miss too often from there. Eichel with a snipe.
And a tough finish to the period there from Focus as a late goal by Cad makes it 2-0. I thought that he played pretty well, settled in after that quick opening goal by Cad.
He did have his chances as well, and he did start forcing Cad to the outside until the very end of the period, where Cad did find the open man in the slot, like you said, able to kind of regroup after that initial goal, and the period went on it went out like a light. Like, it's essentially is the first period, only a couple stoppages to play as these guys are just getting after it. Take it away.
Here's Dobson on opening the second period. He's got a goal for Cad already, the 99 overall fantasy card, as he walks out in front, and that one's gonna go as McDavid with close quarters just throws it in, and it's all Cad early in game number one.
And he looked like he's the one that just went down 3-0 by his reaction. But Cad doing a good job starting the period the way he ended it. And man, it was 1-0 the entirety of the first. Just moments into the second, 3-0 Cad.
All right, Matthews now. He's got to find an answer quickly. So far, a couple chances for Focus, but nothing of great danger. Is now Cad looking for more. Down low along the goal line. This is not where you want to see him. Is now... he waits, maybe that far side post play goes, has that covered, sends it into the middle, and Justice Anunin is gonna play that one out. The hero in NHL 21, I believe, as he was a common favorite among the GWC competitors in that year. The former NHL 23 World Championship. As Nurse sends that around to McKinnon. Now to McDavid on the breakout. Dobson's got it. Dobson holds it on the forehand, curls back into the slot, sends that one into the middle. Now Nurse on the breakout. Darnell Nurse spins back around. Over to McCarr. McCarr hits Lemieux. Lemieux with it. Now down behind the net, pinned up along the boards. Focus can't get anything set up and going. It's all one and dones when he enters into the zone, Grizz.
That it is, and again, he has had possession throughout the neutral zone, but he's not been able to string any offense together, but here he goes. And there it goes.
Dobson there to thwart that one, as now he comes out the other way. Here's Couturier. Cad firing down the right side, down behind the net. He's pressured off by Nurse, and now Cad with it in the middle. Read well by Focus, and on the breakout, here goes Daze. Now Jágr with it. Jágr, he's gonna have that one knocked free. Lemieux now on the breakout. He spins back around, sends it up the middle, and that'll be an offside.
And defensively, that's what Focus has to do a little more of. You're going to have to use that active stick. We've seen the way that Cad uses those LTs, the half spins, to protect the puck, and it makes it awfully difficult, especially with a guy like Jágr, to get that puck back off of a bump. So you're going to have to find a way to catch him off guard and get a good stick check.
He's now down behind the net, and maybe a wrap attempt. He spins back around as Ovechkin fires one on. Now Boldy back and forth, up the middle, intercepted. And again, it's all Cad here in game number one. He got off to that hot start, and that is not what you want Cad to have if you are trying to win against him in a best of three. Focus knows this. I think he needs some momentum, though, whether it be an ugly goal. He just needs something offensively. Is now back and forth. Cad pressured there. Still has the puck, and again, just so hard to knock him off. Sanderson to Weber. Shea Weber. I'm going to assume that's his all-star card. Up to Kucherov. Kucherov's got it. Down to Pasternak. Doesn't let it go. Forces it through, and that one's going to go just wide. Boldy now on the breakout the other way to Mike Modano. Across the line is Stanley Cup playoff master set card.
And Cam, without a block on that last possession for Cad, that puck was going in. He had a man wide open backside on the pass, just didn't get there.
Absolutely. Is now Larkin in tight. He can't get that one to go. A glorious opportunity there for the Detroit Red Wing, and that one can't get through. Now Eichel out the other way. He's got a goal in this game for Cad. Stops up, and Lindholm sends him flying off the puck. Now Larkin out the other way. He's crushed along the board. Sanderson's going to bring it back in, and Lindholm doing his best to try and keep everyone off the puck, but there's the quick wrap, and Sanderson is going to make it 4-0.
Cad is cooking. It's 4-0. And man, focus still searching for answers. Like you said, a lot of those one-and-done possessions, not able to garner any opportunities deep in the zone. And Cad is just running away with this game one.
I think that play, that like the quick wrap has been available to him 3 or 4 times so far, and we did not see it a lot, as it's a very, very common goal scored in NHL 23. We did not see it a lot in yesterday's semifinals because it was just being defended very well. However, focus is kind of bringing everything back into the middle, almost because he knows that Cad loves to go into the middle, but it's leaving that wrap attempt wide open, and he's got to have some sort of awareness of that because Cad's just going to keep going for it. As now in the breakout, 4-0 off the timeout, Matthews with it. Still plenty of time left. We saw Jost come back from a 4-0 deficit in his semifinal against Pens. Does Focus have the same kind of magic? Josi with it. Trying to go 1v4, but he gets across. He's running out of time. McKinnon now behind the net. Curls back out in front. Cad pressures. A good stick, and that is going to do it for the second period as Cad running away with this one 4-0.
Yeah, and again, at this point in the game, you're kind of just playing to see what works for game two. Again, 4-0, going to be awfully hard to come back, but we did see a 4-0 comeback in the way of Jost. Jost did not end up winning that game, of course, but he's seen that, or he's shown that it can be done. And this year, it is just insane. The way that the puck swings happened, it comes off of that first goal. When you finally start to believe that you can score back-to-back possessions. You're right in this game.
No, absolutely. You can score in bunches, as now Matthews looks to make it 5, and a good defensive play to get back early by Focus. Now McKinnon weaving in and out, still has it to McDavid on the backhand, and that one's gonna be knocked aside. McKinnon now behind the net, Focus getting some offensive zone time across to McDavid, and he makes it 4-1 as McDavid will hammer that one home.
Look at the dungeon. He's got a light on, but just, oh man, he's played an awfully dark room. So Focus, all right, finally able to get on the board. But again, it doesn't come off of a long possession. He just attacked and went right to the net. So good job there, McDavid, getting on the board for Focus, 4-1.
Now McDavid out the other way, crushed there. And again, maybe a quick one from Focus, and this gets interesting. You have mentioned that Cad can get a little rattled from time to time. Matthews now with it. Back and forth he goes. And again, look at the quick movement there. Sends it over to Ovechkin, now to Dreisaitl. Krupp can't bump him off. He's got unstoppable force, and that is going to be tough to handle.
Absolutely right, and especially when you're as good at those half spins as Cad is, you look up and down his lineup, and he's got players he knows he can just simply work that move with.
As now McKinnon rips one on, and Noonan's going to hold that, but he says it's May. We're going to play that out. Jágr now with the turnover, and it's right back in. As now behind the net, look, and he read that quick wrap well, defended it there. Now Couturier with it. Down low, a good play defensively by Focus, and now Modano out the other, sending that one up, intercepted, and back in. He is having a heck of a time trying to break the puck out as Cad's aggressive defense in the neutral zone at his blue line is just stifling him. As now Ovechkin, back and forth he goes. Curls that one around. Sorry, that's Jágr. Back and forth Cad goes, and this is extremely difficult to deal with. McKinnon now over to Jágr. No shot yet. And there Couturier goes far side, and that one goes into the corner. On the breakout now, Makar. Makar with it. Tossing that one up. It goes down the length of the ice. Now Cad on the breakout. Speeding down the wing. He's got a step. Cad right down behind the net on the forehand. Stops up, waits for pressure, gets it, and Krupp is able to knock him off the puck. Weaving back and forth over to McDavid. He's got a goal for Focus in the third period. Looking for more, but again, turned over, and now Couturier out the other way. Now Matthews saucing that one up. Nice spin move, can't get through. Krupp has it, Pasternak will pick it up. Dobson now on the breakout. Kind of a mess in the neutral zone as both of them trade turnovers, but now Matthews holding it on the back end. Now down behind the net, spins back around, tries to get out in front, can't, sends it across, and that one goes to the point. Yossi now. He said in his interview, no point shots. He's not Junior Pens. McDavid at the faceoff dot. Curls back around to Matthews, sends that one to McKinnon. No shot yet. Matthews rips one on, and that one's going to be stopped. McKinnon still holding on to it. Sends that one across and intercepted as it goes wide. And now Cad looking to calm things down. Tavares across the line. He's bumped off the puck. Spins it back around to Pasternak. David Pasternak. He's going to lose control. He's held up along the boards. The Krupp out in front, and he can't get that one through. Now Yossi. Yossi's got it back and forth. As he walks the line now into the zone, here's Daze. Daze, no shot yet. Read well, and that aggressive defense behind the net, Cad, is making sure that he takes away the far side post play as well as the quick wrap. A very good defense right behind his net so far in this one. Daze now in the breakout, the Draisaitl. Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, you do live and die by that for Cad, as when he does that and commits, if you're able to slip that check behind the net, you're going to have a wide open pass in front. And we've seen those go against Cad as well, but working for him here in this game.
As now Faxa on the breakout, over to Svechnikov. Svechnikov has it under a minute to go in the third. Cad looking to cruise to a game one win. Petrangelo on the breakout. Carries the puck up to Lemieux. Nice play there. Still has it. They both puck chop away. Cad will come away with it on the breakout. Quick play to McDavid. McDavid, nice hold of the puck. Weaving back and forth. Faxa, no shot yet. Sends that back around. Over to Medano to Forsberg. Forsberg now over to Lindholm. Now Boldy. Boldy has a step, sends it to Medano. He stops up, sends it across, intercepted, but Focus comes away with it with Forsberg. Tries to walk out in front. Cad, good player switch. And again, he's just taking away that behind the net ability, and Focus having a heck of a time trying to answer for it. Now Medano wraps it around. He scores with 5.6 to go. Maybe a bit of a morale boost going into game two, but it's 4-2.
Yeah, I won't do anything for this game, just not enough time left. But again, that belief that you can start to score and get those goals against a player like Cad will certainly go a long way into starting here game number two.
No, I agree. And I think that we saw kind of what we expected to see just going into this, as Cad is just, he really flexed offensively early on in that game. You saw a lot of the spins and controlling the puck down low, and Focus didn't really have an answer for it. But I think the biggest issue for Focus was his breakouts. Like, how many times did he just get across his blue line, turn it over, and it was right back in? And that's just going to be awfully tough to deal with going up against someone like Cad. So 1-0 for him in the best of three. He's one game away from booking his ticket to Washington. Let's take a look at the highlights from game number one. As now Cad behind the net. Back and forth he goes, tries to walk out in front, and there, the backhand forehand early on was huge, but then this was kind of a backbreaker, trying to survive the period. He doesn't get the intercept by Lindholm, and I don't know where Anunin was going. He flew right out of the net, and a late goal there for Cad. Right off the draw in the second, though, he was right back at it as Cad working around, tries to get all the way out in front, and there you see Focus had two players stuck behind the net because he followed him all the way back, and that's just going to be easy for someone like Cad. And again, a bad player switch is going to allow that quick wrap. Haven't seen a lot of that so far in the last 2 days, but Cad able to pull it off here. In the third period, Focus started to come to life a little bit as Matthews was able to send it to McDavid, close quarters on, and throws it in as he was able to make it a 4-1 game. And then late in the third period, Medano gets within two, but that was all that was going to be in game number one between Focus and Cad. So what do you think is going to be the biggest adjustment for Focus going in if he's going to have a shot to force a game three?
I think you saw it numerous times in those highlights. You also pointed it out. His player switching simply has to be better. And he's switching late. He's switching to the wrong guy. He's pulling the wrong guy out of position. Getting two guys stuck behind the net, you just cannot do that against a player like Cad. And I think that is one of the biggest skill gaps in this game. Player switching is awfully difficult to get a handle on this year especially. And it really separates the best of the best from that next tier down. And I think Focus has to adjust and not get his guys caught. You can't chase with one switch and chase with the second one and leave two guys out of position because he just had no chance to cover that cross crease play.
No, absolutely. And it's going to be interesting to see. I think he's going to need Focus is going to need a much better start in game two if he is going to force a game three. But like we mentioned in the intro, if you made it this far, you've got a shot to beat anyone. And we are going to find out in game number two. Don't go anywhere, guys. We'll be right back with game number two.
Invention is an act of determination to go where you couldn't before, achieve goals that once felt out of reach. That's why Honda engineers didn't just redesign the Pilot Trail Sport, they built the most off-road capable Honda SUV ever, the all-new Pilot Trail Sport, part of the Honda line of rugged vehicles. Honda, official vehicle of the NHL.
Welcome back as we are here with day number two of our North American console finals as we are trying to find our final two players that will join DunkinDeli and Jose in Washington, and we might have one in game number two. Cad one game away from booking his ticket to DC. Will Focus answer back and force a game three? We're about to find out. Here we go. It is game number two. And we'll see if Focus has a better start. He's got to be locked in early as now Cad with Heiskin in across the line. Good poke check there. As now he breaks the puck out to McDavid. McDavid to Matthews. Matthews weaving back and forth at the faceoff dot. Pressured there, but still has it. Here's Matthews with it. On the backhand, and a couple of great poke checks by Cad early on to thwart that offensive play. Dobson, he had the early goal in game number one. Over to McDavid now. That was Cad's favorite card, or the one that would do the most damage. He looks to do some damage in game two. Matthews now down behind the net. And again, both players trying to go to the same areas, but defending it well. Matthews into the corner boards. He's got it. A far side player trying to get open. Focus sees that it's covered, can't do much. And now Ovechkin in the breakout, but a good step up there on the poke check. A shot on, doesn't go. Now McKinnon over to Matthews. No lane on the far side. Now he waits for it. A nice saucer play, but he can't get it through. As a much better start, Grizz, from Focus.
Yeah, and Focus, you got to work the pace of play here. He did mention that's one of his biggest weaknesses early on in games, being overly aggressive, turning the puck over too often. So he looks settled in. So he should be able to control this a little bit better if he doesn't chase Cat.
He needs the opening goal, in my opinion, but we've got Makar here. Can't get it through. Now to Dreisaitl. Over to Lemieux. He's got a step. And Cad gets back with a great poke check. Now McKinnon with it. Down the boards to Couturier, the trailer. Turns that one over, and both players, some key turnovers at the last second to stop any of their offensive chances. Jágr on the breakout. Jágr spins back around. Across to Jágr. Cad's got it. Maybe a quick wrap attempt. He thinks otherwise, and a shot far side is going to be saved by Anunin. Now to Medano. He had a goal late in game one. Focus has it on the backhand. Stops off. Sends it across, and it'll be intercepted by Makar. Under 10 minutes to go in the first. These players do not like stoppages. As Cad's got it. Along the faceoff dot. Pressure there. Back out to Kucherov, and that just slight hesitation as he tries to go far side goes just wide. I think we're going to see a lot of that out of him. We've seen it a couple times, but a partial break and a poke check once again, Grizz. The poke checks by Cad have been infuriating for Focus.
Such a good opportunity there. and just again not able to create enough separation as a beautiful poke check by Cad. But for Focus, one interesting thing about him, he can put both of his legs over his head.
I'm not sure how to respond to that, as that'll be an offside.
Yeah, just a little fun fact in there. He said he will not show it on stream, but something interesting to know. Always love those little tidbits that you can find out about what makes these guys a little extra special.
That's why we've got you on the broadcast, for insights like that, Grizz. It is a 0-0 game, 5 minutes to go in the first period of game two. Focus has got to win this one in front of Garen, and that one's going to be shot on. I think he was trying to go upstairs, doesn't get a lot of it,
yeah,
and that one will be stopped.
And it looked like he had daylight too, Cam. He just didn't get that shot exactly where he wanted it. Definitely a grade A chance to score, left off the board.
Focus, definitely a better start here in game two. Can he hold the line? He can, as he's gonna go all the way back into his own zone. Now in the breakout to Petrangelo. Brings that one back around. Now Matthews has it, walks the line. Lindholm to Petro. Back to McKinnon as he walked that one around. Unstoppable force activated. It is a shot on, doesn't go, as that one was rifled upstairs, but it's off the bar, and Cad still alive here in a 0-0 game. A minute to go in the first. Back into the slot, now back to Heiskanen, and he activates from the point, walks all the way down. Heiskanen with it, all the way back out in front. Focus trying not to overcommit, but he does there. Still has it though, is Cad. Petro. Player switch there. Lindholm just making sure he does not have that pass across, and defended well. Out of the zone, they reset, and maybe time for one more shot. McDavid, and that'll do it for our first period.
Yeah, and another thing you're seeing out of Cad is using his player's abilities in game, especially. So Focus is going for those hits, and those bumps are being absorbed, and it's pulling him out of position as well. Cad wasn't able to attack on that last chance there. But something that Focus needs to be awfully careful of, if you're going to run for that hit, you cannot take yourself too far out of position, because you'll get stuck in that animation. You'll leave yourself way out.
We'll see what he can do in the second period, as 20 minutes are behind us in game number two. Cad wins this. He goes to Washington and will join Duncan and Jose. Krug's got it. So he walks back along. Not going to be able to bump him off the puck, as Focus battles away with Ovechkin, and that Ovechkin has been brutal to deal with. Now Matthews has it. Spins it down low. Pressured there by Focus. A good player switch, and he waits, and he takes his shot, and that's what he's got to do defensively. A great player switch and good activation there to knock it free. Now down in the boards. Good hold there by Cad, but Focus will come away with it. Intercepted on the cycle. Now Dobson back out to Ovechkin. Good poke check though with the red line. Now Yossi's back in. Here's Yossi. Focus has it with McKinnon. McKinnon to McDavid. It slides into the crease. Markstrom's going to play it out. You can't do that, as that one is going to be dunked home. And Focus takes a 1-0 lead.
And Focus has officially gained admission to the Duncan University.
Would have to think DunkinDeli is proud, as Focus takes a 1-0 lead as he hammers that dunk home. Two-hand jam, as they say. McCarr now on the breakout. We'll see how Cad reacts to being down for the first time in the series. Now Focus sends it across, and Markstrom will hold on to that, and he's going to hold on to that play.
And just responding to a comment in chat to Hansley, no, Duncan actually did not lose 2-0 to Jost. That was Junior Pens, and that went to game three, but Duncan did win his series 2-0 against Sauce.
Now Forsberg off the faceoff, shot on. That one's going to be blocked. Couturier now in the breakout to Jágr. Big bump there. Focus with a much better game here in game number two. Backs right in. Here's Cad behind the net, walks all the way around. Boldy with some pressure. I believe that's Lindholm walking out in front. A shot on, that one's not going to go. As Nurse now with it on the breakout. This is where he had some trouble in game one, as the pressure's on. He just sends it out as he was on a line change, and it's turned over right back in for Cad. The breakout struggles continue for Focus. as Cad's all over it. Daze with a quick turn. Now he gets into the zone, has some space, self sauce is now into the corner, but tears that poke check, and right back out of the zone is Cad. Cad's got it across the line. That's Heiskanen down behind the net. Heiskanen walks out in front. A shot on, that'll be blocked, and Draisaitl will come away with it. Here's Lemieux. Makar up to Draisaitl. Draisaitl now to Daze. He's pressured there by Heiskanen. Still has it to Lemieux. Lemieux walks in. Draisaitl now picks it up in the corner. Now back to Krupp. Krupp has it. Walks right in. Stops up. No far side. One-timer open. So he rotates once again. Here's Daze. 7 minutes to go in the second. And this is a much better performance from Focus. Holding on to the puck. No wasted shots here. As Krupp walks in. Shot on. A little backhand forehand. And Cad will hold on to that.
Well, a game like this definitely plays in favor of Focus as well, because he was able to keep it close throughout this entire game, and he didn't let Cad use his speed to the outside like we typically see, and he just waited. Waited this turn. Cad doesn't really have any too threatening chances, and then Focus, of course, gets the dunk, but he's looked much better in this game, a lot more calm and patient.
Absolutely, as he is dialed in. Much more than game one. Modano now over to Boldy. Boldy spins around. Modano's got it towards the net, and that one doesn't go. Cad now on the breakout to McDavid. Holds it over to Matthews. Matthews has it. Josi kicks that one free. Matthews drives that one wide, and he's going to be tripped up, and Cad's going to go on the man advantage late in the second.
All right, let's see if he can cook up a nice power play here, as Cad maybe gonna use his good buddy in Ovechkin, his favorite player as well. And he's been watching him for 10 years.
The booze rained down. Off the draw, win. Lindholm will intercept that pass from Makar. Now Petra on the breakout to McDavid, and he's met immediately. Again, the breakouts continue to be an issue for Focus. Lindholm is gonna put pressure on, and he just gets that poke check free. Sends that up to McDavid, trying to kill the clock. Petro, far side to Matthews. Matthews gets in on the sauce. Matthews sends it to McDavid, shorthanded, comes away with it. Matthews can't get the shot away. That's a great poke check there, late by Cad. Saved a shorthanded goal for Focus. Now across the line, 30 seconds remaining in the power play. Couturier's got it now down behind the net. On the forehand, now backspins around, he scores! What a play there, and McKinnon's gonna hammer home the one-timer.
And there is McKinnon tying this game up for Cad, as he just found his man at backdoor. He's the power play to his advantage. You cannot go down a man against someone as lethal as Cad.
1-1. We'll see if Focus has the answer. Tavares has it across the line. Slavkovsky will intercept. Now Larkin out the other way. Here's Dylan Larkin across the line. Sends that to Slavkovsky. Back to Josi, the trailer. He walks in from the point on the backhand. Waiting for something to open up. Cad covering that far side post play. Now down behind the net. He runs out of room. Slavkovsky's not able to get it. Now with under 30 seconds to go, here goes Cad with time for one more. Kucherov across the line. Into the middle. Here's Cad late in the second period. No shot yet. Still has it on the goal line. He misses that check towards the net. And that'll do it for the second period.
And Focus, he's starting to look like last game a little bit there. Just could not get that puck back. Fortunately for him, no last minute goals like in game number one. So again, for Focus, still able to keep it close. He does give up the power play goal to Cad, but you're still tied. You got the dunk. You've looked good offensively. He's looked very patient offensively. He's gotten some zone time that he did not get in game one. Certainly has looked like a different player in this game. So, hey, see if you can win this one here. 1-1 game.
Big game here for Focus. Big period. Tied at ones in game two. He needs to win this one to force a game three. As now Cad looking to cook down low. On the forehand, waits for some support as he's got that backside player now available to him. As now he walks out in front, and it's just gonna be so hard to knock him off the puck. Focus now tries to put some pressure on, but that one is gonna do it on the bump attempt, and now maybe a 2-on-1, but he just missed that as a brutal self-sauce there from Focus. Broke up what would have been a 3-on-1. Sauced out the other way to Matthews. He hits McDavid in stride. McDavid stops up at the blue line. Now Focus walks into Matthews. Matthews now in the corner. Spins around, intercepted, and now Cat out the other way to Dobson. Across the line. Still has it. Here's Cat. Walks towards the net. A good poke check there. Now McDavid. Good job to not chase him behind the net. As Cad looking to get something to open up behind the net. Has that far side player, and that one is, I think, blocked. As Focus read that one well. Couturier down to McKinnon. McKinnon now on the backhand towards the net. Off the pads and out. Danger averted. 13 minutes remaining in the third period of game two. Now Focus into the corner. He spins back around. Still has it on the forehand. No shot to Makar. McKinnon now with it as he cycles it around. Now to Medano, a shot on, and that one's going to be stopped. Dreisaitl has it. Unstoppable force on the big Edmonton Oilers center. Over to Makar now. Spins back around to Josi as he activates his defenseman, but no shot on. And now Cad out the other way. Cad to Jágr. Jágr straight line into the zone. The 95 team builder, he went for the short side. Rapp doesn't get it, but Jágr picks up the puck back across and he scores. Sends that one over and Nathan McKinnon is gonna make it 2-1.
All right, and Focus did a good job weathering the storm early on in this period, but finally able to break through as you see the stick facing the wrong way, facing outside instead of inside there for Focus. Tape to tape pass, back door. Rips that one into the net, and a lead here for Cad. Game two.
Yeah, do you think Focus has it in him? I think he's been much better in game two. But we're going to see.
I do.
Here.
He's had a couple of really, he's had a couple of good chances from the slot cam, and he cannot give up the next one. We mentioned that a lot in games like this. 2-1, 1-0, stuff like that. Can't give up that next goal. See if he can get it here.
2-on-1, and again, just thwarted by that poke check. And
take over for a second. Got some technical difficulties going on. A 3-1 game for Cad as he is able to get the next one. But here comes Focus working his way up ice with Lemieux. Gotta act fast here. Turn that one over. Cad. Right hand side. Matthews working this one up. Dobson. Nice tape to tape pass. Jarred loose at the line. As now Focus has 4 minutes to get two goals.
Thank you.
let's go.
What a shot.
Yo, what's up, guys? Asher here. We're here with Mark Scheifele from the Winnipeg Jets. We're taking on some NHL 23. We're playing a little 1v1. What do you feel like your chances are in this one?
Very low. My video game skills are not up to snuff.
Well, we're going to hop into this and we'll see what happens. Let's get it.
They have so much more than when I played, and I was like, this is like 15 years ago. They have so many more things going on.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's tough to just pick up and play after you have it for a while.
I know, honestly. I'm like actually like looking at the buttons. I feel like my dad when I played with him, and he's like, he'd call it a game box. Oh, I won the faceoff.
There you go. So we were talking earlier in here about who the hockey goats are. You know, Wayne Gretzky came up a lot, but speaking of that, I've heard that you own a goat farm.
I do have two goats.
I was not aware. Oh, okay, it's just two goats.
I have two goats.
Not anything like crazy.
No.
Oh, there's the first one. That was worth two, but the next one's worth two.
Okay.
So you're good. So tell me about your goats.
Yeah, so their names are Tom and Tiger, after Tiger Woods and Tom Brady. My girlfriend, Britt. Oh, let's go!
What a shot.
Britt ended up getting, she thought, like, she was thinking of getting me a goat for my previous birthday.
Okay.
Being, like, thinking it would be like some kind of fun joke that all of a sudden we'd have a goat in the condo. And then we ended up getting a house with a little bit of land in Winnipeg. And she was like, what if we got two goats? And I was like, well, where would they live? And she was like, oh, I figured they would do this or they would do.
Uh-huh.
And she had a whole plan. And I was like, okay, if you take care of them, then, you know, you go for it.
That's gonna be it.
Spetchy boy.
I think you'll have a bit more luck in the real NHL.
Come on,
this year.
Make the save.
Hey, it was a blast, man. Pleasure as always.
Thanks
for talking goats. And that's it for this one. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.
All right, so crazy finish there, but Cad was able to get things done in game number two, Grizz. You know, what did you see and what happened is Focus was playing much better in the beginning of that game too.
Well, the wheels just kind of fell off the wagon and Focus did a good job early on, again, keeping Cad to the outside. But then Cad kept doing what Cad does, those half spins, worked his way inside, got that cross crease pass. And that's kind of all she wrote. He attacked quick and got those back-to-back goals to end the game. And he'll be moving on.
That he will. Let's hear from the man himself. Let's bring up, there he is. Hello, Cad, can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Look at that smile as he is moving on to DC. All right, so you've made the land. You are one of now three players that will be competing for the North American Championship. Who would you rather play if you had to play one of Jose or DunkinDeli?
In the finals of like in DC?
Yeah, let's just say even in round one, who would you rather play?
Probably Duncan, because I think Joe's is better.
All right, that's what I wanted to hear. I wanted
let's
to
go.
See. Okay, now we got to hope for a Duncan and Cad right. game. See, that's
because you
we
know
get
Duncan's going
to
run with it.
Let's go.
All right, so let me ask you this. You said that you believed Gren to be your biggest opponent, your biggest threat in this tournament. And we saw what you were able to do. You were able to take him down. So now that he's out of the mix, you've moved on. Do you think this is your best shot to win this year?
I think this year, like, I'm playing really good. And I knew if I beat Grant, I can, like, honestly, like, go and win this tournament and fight, like, just play my best. So that's what I'm going to do in DC and try and, like, make it to Nashville.
Oh man, you played fantastic in that series and you have all year round. It's been fun watching you kind of evolve as a top end competitive player over the years. And we'll see if this is in fact your year as we will see you in DC. So again, congrats on winning the series. We're going to say goodbye to you and bring on Focus as unfortunately, my man, it did not go as planned. You looked much better in game two. What was it about game one that kind of got away from you, and what adjustments did you make in game two?
You know, I wouldn't want to say tech issues. Maybe I would have liked a little more time to get used to the equipment I was playing with. Because partially the reason I don't stream is because there's a little bit of delay between my Elgato and my TV. But I'm not going to say that. I felt like I was a step behind the whole time. He was reading me very well. I chased too much. I mean, both games were pretty much 3-1. I mean, with the exception of like last second goals, right, to end it off. So it was close, but I mean, overall, I just felt behind. I knew Cad was going to be good offensively. I expected more rush out of him, to be honest, because usually I like to do the half wall and like below the circle stuff that he did, but he guarded it really well by switching over, moving someone low, moving someone high. So both my half spins were kind of taken out. So I think that's what caught me off guard a lot, was how well he played defensively. And that's probably a testament to how he beat Grant.
We're going to see you back here next year. You did a good job this year, making it the furthest you've made it. And bigger steps next year, maybe?
I think I'll come back next year if Cam actually styles his hair for the next stream. How about that? Because a buddy looked like he woke up.
I'm going to have to do it. I didn't want to look like Grizz and take a comb and just go backwards with it. Come on now. All right. Well, okay. I mean, guess I'm going to have to do my hair.
Or you could be like me and just like...
get rid of it all.
You know.
Yeah, then you don't have to worry about it. I guess you're right there. All right. Okay. Fair enough. Exactly. Fair enough. Well, man, it's awesome talking to you. It was great watching your run here. And I think we'll see you next year, as I will definitely make sure my hair is in better shape. So, all right, Grizz, let's go over the second game there, as I think we just dropped off right near the end there. So let's take a look at some of the replays.
Yeah.
Second period starts off, and again, it was a much better start for Focus in this one. But there it is, the dunk slams that one home, and Focus looked like he was in control of this game, but it was the late minute goals right there as he gets that one through. And McKinnon did a lot of work in this series for Cad, as late in the third, a good read there of the short side wrap, but he waited. And again, it's just the ability to force those through and get just open very quickly is what set Cad's apart, as we've got a goal right here as Cad is gonna take it home and move on to DC. Let me get your, we got Cad's input there and who he would rather play. But out of our three competitors so far, who do you think has got the best shot of winning? Who would be your favorite if you had to, place a friendly wager of our three finalists?
Man, it's awfully tough. And I want to go Jose, because I think he has the highest ceiling of all the players. I think he can be the best offensively. And he's shown the ability to come back, and he has poise, he has LAN experience, all of the above. But it's awfully tough, because then you look at Cad and what Cad's been able to do this year as well. One of them knocked off Regs, one of them knocked off Gren. And then you have Deli, who is just the wild card. I mean, Deli can run the table. So I'm going to go Jose. I'm going to go with my gut. I'll go Jose.
Because there's not going to be anyone louder than Deli in person. I feel like that's an underrated thing that doesn't get talked about enough. He could knock someone off their game. I mean, yeah, he jumped out of his chair multiple times in Florida. But let's take a look at our bracket, see where we're at, give you a little bit more of a visual representation here of our day two of our NA console finals. Cadcooks for his Chicago Blackhawks moved on past Focus. And on the docket, our final semifinal is Boily against SkyEstake. And I mentioned going into today that this was probably my favorite or most anticipated for myself in terms of semifinals, because it's two of the best hut players that just haven't had that big success. Boily was able to make Carolina, but he was in the Stadium Series event, but wasn't able to beat your boy Frank in that. I kind of thought that was going to be like his moments in terms of NHL esports. But both of them absolutely nuts on the sticks. And I'm personally excited to see SkyEstake, kind of see how he handles the pressure, because I don't know if there's many better players that just, if you load up and went into hut champs, SkyEstake is not someone you want to go up against. So Let's take a look at our player portraits, however, for Boily and Sky's taken.
Boily, the underdog, taking on the reigning North American champion, Regs.
I know I'm good offensively.
What a goal for Boily, and Boily's gonna answer right back. Looking for another one, Boily! Boily, what a goal!
Nasty goal there from Boily.
Behind the net, and he ends it, Boily!
Come on, let's go!
Boily is gonna win the series in overtime.
Bam! Shut up! Come on, bro!
I'm happy. Job is not done. So. Yep.
My name is Nick Ilievsky. I'm 20 years old. My gamer tag is Sky is Taken. I feel like everybody that I've played is really good. I feel really good beating some of those top players. My next opponent,
Boilies!
His strength is definitely his offense, just like mine. Our play styles are pretty similar.
Bang!
All right, again, super excited for this one. I think we've got Sky is Taken on the docket first, so let's bring him in. There he is. Hello, my man. It has been a long time coming. You have dominated in Hockey Ultimate Team for years. I mean, what would a day be without you sniping Henrique in Hut Champs? You know, you have really plowed through the competition year after year, but now you've got a shot to make it to DC. How are you feeling going into this matchup?
I'm feeling good overall, but I gotta be honest, I would have rather played somebody, anybody else besides Boily, honestly, so we'll see how it goes.
Well, it's certainly gonna be a tough matchup for you, Sky, but just one of the most disgusting players on the sticks. Do you think you're gonna lean on your offense here, or are you gonna try to shore up your defense against Boily?
I'm gonna try to stop him behind the net the best I can, but I think it's gonna be high scoring, so we'll see.
You've got an awesome background, I'm not going to lie. What's the stick setup? Yours or players?
Those are my brother's. They're all broken from when he played. So, yeah.
All right, let me ask you this. I asked Cad this. What is going to be your most impactful card if you are successful today in this series?
Probably Jager, just because of unstoppable force. It's hard to bump him off the puck, so.
Jager has been one of the GOATs in NHL 23. Now, go get ready, man. You've got a huge matchup. Good luck. Can't wait to see how it plays out. We've got to go have a word with his opponent in Boily. As there he is. Boily, can you hear me?
Nope.
He's texting somebody. There he is. All right, here we go.
Okay, Boily.
There he is. There he is. All right, now. We got to meet in Carolina. It looked like it was going to be you took down Regs in that first round outside in the colder weather at the truck, which was honestly one of my favorite events to cast, but you weren't able to get it done. Do you think that experience though, however, is going to help you win this series and more than just this series, you know, help you win this year's NHL 23 World Championship?
Oh yeah, definitely. I took so much experience from then, and I'll control my stress and control my game, and I'm confident.
So my man, you have a lot of experience playing real life hockey. You play at a very high level, AAA in, I believe, Quebec. You want to touch on, has that helped mold your game in game?
Yeah, of course. And my preparation example, it's something familiar to me.
I'm excited, Boily. I'm excited to see how your series goes. Go get ready, slam a few more waters, and it's gonna be awesome to watch. So good luck, my man. Grizz, let's break down these guys a little bit more. Let's take a look at our first player profile. As we take a look at Boily, as we'll throw him up on the screen. There he is, Grizz. Walk us through the player profiles.
So Boily, age 19, from Montreal. Favorite players, Mitch Marner, of course. And he did beat Regs at the Stadium Series Open. The enemy, again, so him and Cad both. So he's also an electrician in real life. He did just graduate from school in the past 2 weeks.
That's, Hey, that's not bad. Good for him. Again, one of the more fun players to meet in real life. I had a blast talking with him in Rally. I'm excited to see how this one goes. Let's throw up his opponent in Sky is Taken.
Yeah, so Sky actually not too far away from myself and you, Cam. He's from Webster, New York. I think he's a very efficient goal scorer. Again, one of the more disgusting players on the sticks. His favorite player is Evgeny Malkin because he's a high emotion player. I will have his family and the Ennis gang cheering him on in chat.
That he does.
You remember that from last year.
All right. we are almost all set for our final semifinal of the North American Console Finals as we find our last representative that will go to Washington to battle out for the North American Championship for the NHL 23 World Championship. But don't go anywhere, guys. We'll be right back after this. Welcome back in. We are just about set for our final semifinal. We are going to jump right into it. It is Sky is taking on Boily in our final semifinal of the tournament as we're following Sky, I believe, back to Shen as he's going to walk it in. Intercepted there. Now McKinnon on the breakout doesn't get it. We'll see Jager looking to be the most impactful player for Sky. And for someone, and again, these are two of the best players in Hockey Ultimate Team, Grizz, but they haven't really had their big win yet. What do you think is the most important thing for either of them if they're going to have success?
Well, you got to open it up and you need poise. So when we get to this point in the tournament, year after year, it's kind of been a thorn in the side of both of these players as they run up against some of the better players in the space. Against those guys that just do have that experience winning. So a win like this could be another really good example of how they can push their game to the next level.
You're not wrong there as Boily in down low, sends it back to Dahlin over to Krupp. On the back end, that back around, tries to force it through the middle, doesn't get it. Now Shen out the other way, but he's gonna reset. So I believe that is the Luke Shen MSP. The Stanley Cup variant, as now he gets into the zone. Boily's going to intercept that, and there's Timo Meier all the other way. Speed down the wing, maybe a 2-on-1. Curls back into the middle, but it's a full four-man collapse into the slot for Sky, and now he's got a shot 1-on-1, holds it wide, and he can't get it to go. Narrowly missing that one. Boily, as we go end-to-end here to start game one, as power to Gretzky. Haven't seen Gretzky yet, now Meier. Meyer's got it, still holding the puck, and a good poke check there from Sky, and he's out the other way for Couturier. Couturier now with it. A nice spin into the middle, still has it. Look at the weave there, now back to Josi. Behind the net, Jager comes away with it. No room, avoids the poke check, now down behind the net. As he waits with that puck, waiting for pressure. Boily doesn't give it, but Couturier is gonna hammer it home regardless, and it is a 1-0 game.
And there it is, setting up a shot behind the net, forcing that one out in front. Sky takes the first lead of this game one.
He's now Boily in down deep. He's gonna lose that one. Jager now on the back end, Boily looking for an answer. 1-0 for Sky in game one. Over to Makar, he walks it. Over to Pasternak, that shot's gonna be on, kicked out. Boily now threatening to tie things up. Now down behind the net. As he looks to break it out, now it's Sky. And here we go. Lemieux in the neutral zone. Over to Josi, now to Lemieux. Lemieux squeaks through and down behind the net. Curls back out in front, no reset, now McDavid. McDavid in. Behind, walks out, and it's a very slow wrap there. Doesn't get the quick animation, and it is 1-0.
Yeah, he got the slow wrap in, and a difference you're seeing between Series 1 and Series 2 especially with the way that they're controlling their guys. They're switching very fast to set up their computers in the right spot along the pipe. They're not overcommitting, overpressuring, etc., but still able to get that wrap off clean. It just wasn't a fast wrap that we know can go in this game.
As now Boily out the other way, behind the net to break it out. It's now Boily. Boily into the zone. Still has it to Wegkrup. Now back to Dahlin. Dahlin walks into the slot. Still has it. He fires that one far side, and it is now 1-1.
All right, Boily just weaves his way into the slot and picks his corner with that 99 Dahlin. He let that one rip.
All tied up at one, as both of these players going to book their ticket to DC. Now Sky, he waits for some pressure, doesn't have it. Spins back around, nice rotate there to Lemieux. Lemieux looking to back it out. He's bumped off the puck. Krupp now out the other way, sauces it to Rantanen. Now to Matthews. Matthews now. Can he get free? Holds it up, good defense. Over to Matthews, and his goalie laid down. But a Pocheck's gonna bail him out there. That could have been an absolute disaster. Yeah,
here comes Boily. Boily now taking a look down low, and it's gonna turn that one over to Sky. Kicked out free and covered up. Laid right back out as Sky looking to get the last chance on his beard. Turned over a shot. Oh man, that was awfully close. 5 seconds to work with here in the first. And we'll see one last shot from Skyline Drive. Markstrom makes the save at the buzzer.
So a great start for both of these guys. They had a really good answer from Boily and a good start from Sky. I feel like we haven't really figured out anything, how the series is going to go from that. They both had traded chances, and none of them really controlled the entire play. It's very even, which is kind of to be expected, as we are almost set for period two of game number one between Sky and Boily. Huge matchup here, as one of these gentlemen will be the final representation for the North American Console Finals.
Sky with the 1-1 game here. It looked like he was going to have the first offensive possession. Turn that one over as Boily walks in. Dahlin, the goal scorer, doesn't get that one through on the centering feed. Sweeps that one up ice. It's Jágr is drilled before he got to the line. Great step by Boily, not working with MacKinnon. Passes that one across. Boily into the offensive zone. Goes in behind the net. Shot score! There it is. Boily takes the lead. Nathan MacKinnon gets on the board. We do now have a 2-1 game. Boily with that quick counterattack, like Cam alluded to. We're not sure quite what kind of game we're going to see. We just know both of these players can score in bunches. You cannot stop them. You can only hope to slow them down. As Boily once again rotates that one down low in behind the goal line, looking for that post play once again that he just scored off of. Didn't connect as Sky gets a good interception, able to block off the area behind the net. Working with McDavid, he's got speed as a man. Back door, wasn't able to get the pass across. McDavid now finding Kopitar. Here's Sky looking to tie this game up. Doesn't let it go in the slot. Now he does block it away by Markstrom. Still attacking here is Sky as Lemieux in behind the net. Kicks that one free, and here comes Boily now with Lemieux. Boily has speed to the outside. Cuts it back off the half wall, sending it across. Doesn't let it go as he's looking for that area behind the net once again. And now Boily has the 2-1 lead, looking to make it 3, and his shot on is stopped. Sky getting a good save from his goaltender there. As here we go, back into the offensive zone, turned that one over. Boily not able to get that pass across into the offensive zone, as Sky still looking to tie this game up. 12 minutes to go here in the second period, a 2-1 game in favor of Boily. As for that shot, Sky not able to connect. Draisaitl misses the mark on that pass. Meyer swings this one up, Pastrnak. Here comes Boily again. Couturier intercepted, as now Boily turned that one over. Sky still looking to tie this game up. We've seen a lot of dominant possession in behind the net for both of these players. As now another interception in the neutral zone, as that one swings down low, looking for the shot. Boily goes in behind the goal, down working below the goal line. Not overcommitting, but he gets it in, and MacKinnon stopped on the doorstep. That one sent up the left-hand side. Nurse finds his man down low. Boily, a good possession there and sent all the way down the ice, played out by Markstrom as Boily looking to push that one goal lead to two. As here we go. Now Couturier swings over to the left-hand side, Dahlin. As, apologies, as Cam is working on his hair from that focus attack. As Cam will be back shortly. Crossing the red line here, Sky. Good chance into the offensive zone. Swings it down low and knocked loose by Boily. A great chance. Back out in front, no shot. Svechnikov in behind the net. He's taken down with a big hit. Gets right back up. Now he's loose and a shot is stopped by Markstrom. Dorier swings that one across. Jager. Here comes Boily as a man in front and robbed again as he had Pastrnak looking. Olmark making the save. He's not going to let that one out. We saw the dunk in the last period or in the last series. No dunk that time.
All right. What a period we've got so far. And holding on to the puck there is Sky. 2-1 lead. Sky, we'll see if he can do some battle back, but a shot on there just goes wide. A great attempt for Boily. Now back to McKinnon. McKinnon with it. Tries to come back out in front. Now to McDavid as he sends that one across. And not able to get it through. End up along the boards. Boily threatening here late in the second period. Turns that one back over. Is now Boily with it behind the net. Trying to get one more before the period ends. McDavid can't catch that one cleanly. As now he comes back around the cycle and a poke check by Sky's goaltender. Over to Jager. He goes back and forth across the line. Still has the puck. Spins back into the face-off dot. Behind the net. Still has it to McKinnon. McKinnon now tries to walk out back in front. He doesn't get it to go. Now McKinnon into the middle. And that'll do it for the second period. As a big answer there from Boily, who has a 2-1 lead.
Yeah, and back and forth action, as Bardon alluded to, all the offense, none of the defense, as these guys really just going all out back and forth. And not a ton of stoppages in our first series, again in our second series, as these players are just zooming up and down the ice.
No, absolutely. And Boily really had Sky on his heels, but he survived that kind of onslaught at the end. We'll see if Sky can come back in this third period. As now sends across into the middle, Sky pressured off the puck immediately. Troops got it now for Boily. Now over to Dahlin. Into the middle, Jager with it. Kicks that one to McDavid, still holding it on the forehand. Back to Krupp. Has it now to Dahlin on the backhand. Ends that one down to McKinnon. Knocks free, and Sky now trying to break the puck out. McKinnon with it over to Shen. Shen sends that one to Jager. Now to Nurse as he breaks into the zone. Forcing him wide is Boily. Sky runs out of room, and he's going to turn that over behind the net. Gets it right back, though. Sky looking to tie things up. Can't get it free out in front. Now still with it again. Good tie up there from Boily. Boily's got it, and he'll fire that one to McKinnon. McKinnon now to Krupp. He curls back into the middle. Allows everyone to get towards the net. As now McKinnon with it. McKinnon behind the net for Boily. Waits for something to open up. Doesn't have it. And a good read there from Sky, but he's going to get it right back. They battle away behind the net. And now they'll break the puck out. Game number one of our final semifinal here at the North American Club Championships. As we are down to our final five players that will compete for that North American crown. As Boily now with it to Meyer. Meyer has it now. Sends it across to Gretzky's in tight there, but a good stick. And now Sky out the other way. Looking to tie things up. Over to Kopitar. Here's Anze Kopitar. Drags it behind the net. Fires that one upstairs. Doesn't get it to go. Now Boily out. Boily stops up at the faceoff dot. Kicks it to Meyer. Rap attempt maybe doesn't get it off. Holds onto it instead. Sends that one around on the breakout is Sky, but he turns it right back over and he takes a tripping call as Boily still has the puck. Back out to Lemieux, great passing play and Gretzky's robbed and Boily's gonna go on the man advantage with 10 minutes to go.
Man, a really, really nice opportunity there. Just does not convert on that chance. And now he's gonna have the man advantage to see if he can extend this lead to two goals. Currently leading 2-1.
A great job there, and Boily's got to do everything, or sorry, Sky has got to do everything he can to survive this power play because Boily is not giving anything up defensively.
And focus, you see what you did? He's wearing a hat now.
Absolutely, man. Enough out of you guys. My goodness. This is why I have a giant hat collection. All right.
What do you mean? You roast me every stream.
That's because you willingly rock a mullet, not for the look, for functionality, all right? It's deserved.
I love it.
Svechnikov with it over behind the net. Shorthanded Couturier. Up to Shen. Now to Nurse. And that one is going to be so, offside.
With the mullet, the goal wasn't even to get a mullet. Like, to get a mullet. It was just, I like having longer hair. I hate having hair on the sides over my ears. So I said, you know what? Give me a fade on the side, turn into a mullet.
This guy, party in the back and business in the front. As Yossi's got it in tight. This guy looking the more dangerous player here, shorthanded. As now, Boily breaks out. Penalty is now over, but a good poke check there. Again, Sky, the more threatening player, down a man. However, Boily's got it, breaks it out, and a good defensive play there from Sky as both of these players playing fantastic here as it's a 2-1 game on the breakout. Back and forth to Jager. Jager, Sky's running out of time. A shot there. I think he was looking for the rebound, and it kicks up a little high. Boily now to Holik, sends that one to McKinnon. McKinnon one-on-one. He spins back to McDavid. Back and forth. What a goal. Are you kidding me?
Oh man, these kids are disgusting. That was just gross. And he's staring down the camera. He knows it. He absolutely knows it. Oh man. Great move by Boily there. He does get that next goal. Pivotal goal for him to try to ice this game. Now leading 3-1, 5:24 left in the third. And it's nice to see some of our competitors that we will see in DC in the chat. Jose and Deli are hanging out.
I mean, I feel like there is not many people that expected the pass there. I thought the shot upstairs was coming, and Boily said, nah, we'll go one more. And a 3-1 game, that was absolutely wild. Anyways, here goes Boily now with a 2-goal lead late in the third. Sky has got to get going now. Behind the net, Boily looking to kill some time. Couturier on the breakout now to McDavid. McDavid spins back into the middle. Intercepted to Pasternak. Big hit there from Shen, knocks him free. And he spins back around, now to Shen. Here's Luke Shen, he's gonna have a set. Now Sky, into the zone. Down low with Shen, fires it towards the net. Markstrom is gonna hold onto that one.
Yeah, and time is starting to tick, right? And you gotta get moving here. You got an offensive zone faceoff to try and bring this within one, as a nice comment in chat. See, Sky, you can score from in front of the net. Of course, that coming from Deli. And you think we're going to see a little trash talk from Deli in DC or what?
I hope so. I tried to get it out of him yesterday. Right? He didn't want to talk to me. Absolutely wild scenes there. As now McKinnon looking to kill the clock out. McDavid on the left side, under a minute to go. Ends it up to Shen. Bends that one over to Nurse. Now Sky with 50 seconds, a full real minute to get to, is a quick wrap attempt, doesn't go. Now to McKinnon, tied up there behind the net. Boy, he's done a great job at that. As McKinnon tries the far side wrap, doesn't go again. Jager now, as he starts to turn on the pressure, but he's running out of time. Now Boily with it, sending it to McDavid, and that should do it, as it is now 4-1, and Boily running away with game number one.
Yeah, he really just put the staple on this game, and there will be no comeback. 30.8 seconds to go. Now a 3-goal lead. Boily taking it to him.
And a tough finish here for Sky. He had some pressure near the end as a pass back in front. And Boily with a 4-1 lead. Looks like he is going to be one game away from DC. Breakout one more time to McDavid. McDavid across the line. Still has the puck. Drives that one wide. Can't get it through into the middle. That one doesn't go. Now Kopitar. Kopitar to McDavid. And just nothing open for Sky as that one's going to go down the length of the ice. And it'll be one game away for Boily as he takes game number one by a score of 4-1. What do you think was the most impressive part of Boily's play there?
His patience with the puck. So, again, everyone thinks he's going to shoot. somehow sees that backdoor pass. I know I'm spamming up. I'm spamming up on the guy before that first pass. And to see what these players are able to do and put together, the field of vision out of Boily specifically in that game was very impressive.
Oh, absolutely. Let's take a look at how we got there to the 4-1 finish. As it was early on, it was Sky. He's able to get that far side post play, and I'm not even sure how, as Boily tried to cover it, but Couturier gets him the 1-0 lead. But then it was all Boily, as Dahlin walks it in, and it's that far side snipe. Just takes what's available to him with the 99 Dahlin. Now 1-1 in the second. Here's McDavid down behind the net, and he answers back with a mirror image goal from Sky, and now 2-1. This was the absolute nails pass here, as McDavid goes back over to McKinnon as he sends that one through and made it 3-1. And then in the dying moments, he sends that one to the backhand, and Holik ices it for a 4-1 win in game number one. What does Sky have to do to come back in the series?
Well, maybe score in front of the net would be a nice start. So you can't rely, as good as he is at scoring that goal, Boily is good at defending it. He proved that against Regs when they played the Stadium Series Open. So when you're going up against someone that knows what you're going to do and knows how to counter that, you have to find a way to adjust. And Sky, we know how good he is. We know he can adjust. It's up here. Can you put that onto the ice, or onto the virtual ice, I should say? And you can't just rely on going behind the net. It's being blocked off by Boily. Well, he did get that goal in the game, so he did score. But after that, nothing. So we got to see a little more out of Sky here offensively.
Absolutely. And we are going to find out if we will see more offense out of Boily right after this.
Wow, it really turned out great.
Yeah, and with the money we saved with Navy Federal Credit Union, it was practically free.
You know, I can't imagine where we'd be without them.
Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission.
Welcome back as we get set for game number two of our second semifinal of the day, as we are into potentially our last game of the weekend. If Boily can beat Sky in game two, he will book his ticket to DC. And we are going to find out right now, as Boily one game away. Sky, if he wins, will force a game three. And here we go. As we're underway, Sky is taken in his Philadelphia Flyer uniforms. Now across the line, he's bumped off the puck, and now Boily into the offensive zone. Can't collect it though, and now Jágr on the breakout, sends it to Schenn. We've seen a lot of him from Sky. Is now Couturier, the goal scorer for Sky. Schenn activates and down low, but Dahlin is gonna intercept and break the puck out. As now towards the net on the backhand. Still has the puck. Curls back out in front, and a great read there from Sky. He sends that one to Schenn. Now to McKinnon. McKinnon back and forth. And a great passing play as he walks out in front. And another great stick check there from Sky. He's defended that well. But some scary times there for Sky is taken as he looks to settle things down. Pressured there. Three men activate there to try and knock him off the puck. And there's just no room to move out there from Boily, Grizz.
Yeah, no, not at all. And a good adjustment so far as well, but now here comes Boily back behind the net where he's very comfortable.
No, absolutely, but again, another good read from Sky on the breakout. We'll see if he can get out of the zone. Boily extremely aggressive on that neutral zone defense, and Boily right back into the zone with Timo Meier. Sends that one down behind the net to Josi. Over to Schenn. Schenn now up to McDavid. Crushed there in the neutral zone, nowhere to go. And now Gretzky's in, and that'll be an offside.
And Sky did do a good job defensively in game one. He did give up a couple of crazy goals. However, he kept the game well within reach for a large majority of that game. He just didn't get that next goal after he opened it up.
Absolutely, Jágr now, down behind the net. Back and forth he goes. Sends that one up to Matthews. Sends that one to Dreisaitl. Over to Matthews. Breaks the puck up to Power. As Couturier now with it for Boily. Boily now into the middle. Pasternak. Here's Couturier. Back and forth in a pretty passing play. Oh. As he is just yelling at the camera.
Oh, man. So last year, if you remember last year, we saw that clip on his player portrait of him punched in the chair. Boily always brings it. He's a very, very emotional player. And you see that right there. He knows that is a huge goal with what's on the line tonight. A trip to DC. We already have three of our potential finalists. We just need one last one here.
Well, he's off to a great start here in game number two. Boily leading 1-0 off the turnover. Here's Tavares to Makar. Makar activates down low. Back and forth. He weaves in and out. Good defense there from Sky. And he looks to break it out now with Jágr. He runs out of room. And again, the neutral zone has been extremely well defended by Boily. Intercept the dough. Can't get it free, and Boily will reset once again. Now into the zone, here's Meyer. Meyer to Gretzky on the backhand. Maybe a wrap attempt, and he just misses that as he came in from the blue line.
Yeah, and again, going to attack right away, looking for that second goal. And Sky's got to find a way to tie this game up. You don't want to go down 2-0.
It's the extra passes that Boily does that have just been absolutely wild. I don't know how he sees that stuff, but behind the net, a good defensive play. Sky has been great in and around his own net. He's defended that far better than a lot of the other players we've seen so far. However, it's offensively that Boily is just defending almost perfectly, and maybe a 2-on-1, but he forces him back to the boards. Pasternak to Jágr. Jágr now on the forehand. Back and forth, out in front, he scores! And Couturier is gonna make it 2-0.
So here we go, as Boily really hammering away with possession, as Sky still searching for answers. Boily able to go up 2-0. 4:39 left here in the first. Boily looking real good as he's trying to eliminate Sky here.
Now on the breakout, Sky has got to get something going now. Pressured there, Kopitar. He's pinned up along the boards. McDavid behind the net. He waits. Still has the puck. Sky back to the point. It's Josi. Josi walks the line now to Larson. Larson over to Kopitar, and a good read there from Boily.
Yeah, great read there, and Sky looking for a good chance. Boily all over that one defensively. Now in offensive zone possession, you got to find a way to start to swing this game in your favor a little bit and draw something up off the faceoff.
Here's Svechnikov as Sky sends it down to Crosby. He's going to have that knocked off. Power now with it. Here's Holík. Holík back and forth, sends it through the middle, can't get it through. Boily now with it again, sends it across. That's intercepted by Sky, and now here goes Schenn the other way. Schenn's got it back and forth across the blue line. Now to Forsberg. Forsberg's in the zone. Behind the net to Svechnikov. Svechnikov's got it. Tries to walk out in front, can't get it through. Now he picks it back up. Crosby to Svechnikov. Over to Crosby and doesn't get it to go. Now McDavid. Over to Nurse. And that'll do it for the first period.
Yeah, and there we go. 2-0 lead taken into the locker room. And he almost had that faceoff play that he wanted off the tie. He had a man in front. Puck just never found its way to the tape. But so down 2-0. Your back's against the wall. You need to just start to get some possession. It starts with stopping Boily offensively. He did only score 2 goals, so you're still very much in the game. But get a turnover and head up ice.
As now Krug tries to get a quick start here for Boily. Leading 2-0, trying to put this one away. Nice spin move, still has the puck, and this guy not able to knock it free. Now he is, now McKinnon on the breakout. McKinnon holds up, now to Schenn. Over to Couturier. Here's Sky looking for a goal to get back within one. Nurse keeps it in, now down to Jágr. Jágr with it, curls into the corner. Can't get the puck, McDavid out the other way. And that'll be an offside.
Yeah, as now again, you found a way to slow the game down a little bit. Boily hasn't had really a threatening chance yet in this period. So an opportunity presents itself for Sky to get himself back in this game. We just haven't seen what we know he's capable of yet here in game two.
Oh, absolutely, as now he tries to send that one through. Here's Larson. He's going to activate from the back out in front to McDavid, and it's a 2-1 game.
Boom, off the rush in front of the net. That's what we're talking about. Way to get on the board. Doesn't need to go behind the net. It's the wide open man back door, and he is very much so back in this game.
As now Shen with it. Shen's got it across the line to Lemieux. Lemieux now holds it wide, fires it out, and that one's going to go. Oh, my goodness. That handcuffs his goaltender, and it's 2-2.
Uh-oh. We got drama here. And just like that, Sky able to tie this game up in the blink of an eye.
What in the world was that? As now Sky is back into this game and the series. As it's 2-2 and now looks to take the lead. Here's McKinnon into the corner. Tries to get back out in front. Pressured there by Boylan. There's just nowhere for him to go. Dahlin gets run over by Shen. As now Sky breaks it out to Lemieux. Lemieux with it now. Tries to get into the middle. Turns it over. Now down to Gretzky. Over to Dahlin. Into the corner, Boyle looking to get back in front. Krupp with it, down to Meyer. Meyer now, that far side post play, not available as Kopitar. Sky reads it well. And now out the other way. Sends that one over to Thompson. Tage Thompson's in front, but that one's intercepted, and now Boyle with McDavid. Nice move, but a good poke check. As now Thompson with it. Turned over Matthews. Sends that one to Dreisaitl. Dreisaitl's into the zone. Still has the puck. Now to Matthews. Back out in front. Thompson's going to bury that one. And Sky has the lead.
All right. So what you're seeing here is a transition of how he's playing his game offensively. He is not trying to use the boards. He's not going down low. He is simply starting at the point of attack and going towards the net in transition with speed, hitting those cross creases. Boyle's been unable to defend it as Crosby, another good chance.
And there's another one as Sky is now cooking. It is 4-2.
What is happening? A completely different player. We said we knew what he was capable of. We haven't seen it yet. Moments after I said that, he flipped the switch and Sky is back.
4-2. He has 4 goals on 4 shots, I believe. That is a solid shooting percentage. Now he's looking for one more and he almost had another. He'll hold on to that one.
And if you're Boyle, you are just stunned at the moment. To be honest, you're just like, what just happened? I was well in the lead. And now you're staring down a 2-goal deficit of your own.
Offensive zone draw here, Shen. Can't get it to McKinnon cleanly. Now to Gretzky. Gretzky with it. Has the puck, walks the line. Sends that one back in Couturier. Now up to Jágr, cuts into the middle, but a good poke check now from Boyle. And Boyle now drives it wide, hits Gretzky in stride. Maybe a wrap attempt, can't get it to go. Omark will hold on to that one. And we'll have a faceoff.
So we've seen the adjustment from Sky. Now that Boyle's down by 2, can he adjust to find himself back in this game? Goes for the quick wrap there, doesn't go. But that area in behind the net is still very much so available to him.
Oh, absolutely. McDavid now on the breakout. Sends that one to Kopitar. Cuts into the middle. Still has the puck. Sends that to Lemieux. Can't get it through. And now Holík out the other way. Over to McKinnon. McKinnon with it. Sends it across, and that's a big save for Sky. Over to Larson with it. Larson now. Tries to break the puck out into the corner. He's pinned off. Bad breakout there for Sky. Holík now tries to get into the middle. He can't. And that one will be held up. Boyle now with it. Boyle's got it, tries to walk. No one's available on the far side. And now Sky trying to break out the puck. He does with Dreisaitl. Stops up at the faceoff dot, turned over, and now McDavid for Boyle the other way. Still has it to Dolly, and he just gets a piece of it. Great look there for Boyle, but he can't beat Ullmark. As now Larson sends that one to Matthews. Over to Dreisaitl. Dreisaitl's got it. Matthews picks it up. Behind the net to Thompson. Thompson walks out in front, can't get it to go. And that'll do it for our second period.
All right, a good period, and Sky woke up. He scored off the rush. So now what Boyle's got to do, he's got to try to deny him at the line. You're giving him too much speed. You're letting those back doors wide open. So now Boyle's staring down that two-goal deficit, down 4-2.
No, absolutely. A big answer back. That second goal, sometimes that's what you need to get going. Boyle obviously wants that one back. Nothing he can do about it. It was a bit of a weak one, but that's what's going to be needed to overcome if you want to win in this tournament. And Boyle now trailing 4-2 in game two. We'll see if he can come back. Nurse now on the breakout. Here is Sky. Sends that one to McKinnon. He's got a step, unstoppable force on. Back and forth he goes. Couturier with it. Behind the net, waits for something to open up on the far side. He can't get the backhand through. And he'll go out the other way. Good poke check there from Boyle. Sorry, from my apologies. Sky now to McKinnon. Sky leading 4-2 after being down 2-0 in game two. As Boyle with a 1-0 series lead. Good poke check at the blue line. Turned over, Holik with it. Now into the middle. Nurse picks it up. Nurse has it to McDavid. McDavid, stutter step at the blue line, can't get through. Into the middle, Lemar with it. Lemieux got it across the line. Over to McDavid. Across the line, here's Lemieux. Lemieux has it. We get a bit of a reset here, Grizz. What's Sky doing that has such a big change in influence here?
Well, again, attacking in transition versus trying to rely on that setup. But now you see him going back behind the net for the first time. He scored all four of his goals from in front of the net. But this time, just again, transition offense, attacking, lightning quick, going right to the net, almost like crashing the net, I would say.
It's now Thompson down low behind the net as he's got it there. Lemieux, not Lamar, as I must be thinking about that giant contract the Baltimore Ravens handed out, apparently.
Unreal.
It's a 4-2 lead here for Boyle. He looks to come back in the third period, but I think this period has gone exactly how Sky wants. Nothing crazy in terms of high danger chances and just running up the clock. Can't get through cleanly. Sends that one over to Jágr. Over to Meyer. Meyer's got it. Maybe a chance here, and he gets it. Holds it off long enough, and Lemieux will score to make it 4-3.
Man, every time we point something out, the opposite happens. No dangerous chances. Immediately after that, Boyle gets on the board, and it's 4-3, and here he comes again.
This next 5 to 10 seconds is going to be important, as Sky's got to make sure he gets away with it here. Again, nerves are probably going to be at an all-time high. He needs to win this game, and he leads by one with only 7 minutes to go. Across the line, it's Rantanen. Cuts into the middle, and that one's going to be stopped. Great opportunity there. Back and forth he goes. Tavares with it. Sends it back to Rantanen, and he scores, and he ties it up. And just yells at us as he gets that to tie up the game at 4.
Yeah, Boyle, what did we say, man? You look angry. There he goes. So he started up 2, gave up 4 in a row, bounces back to tie this game up. It's Rantanen, the big man, getting it done.
All right, now we're going to see who's got the better nerves. Can Sky weather the storm, finish this game off? He had a 2-goal lead with 8 minutes to go in the third. That's gone. Or will it be Boyle, who will avoid a game 3 and win in game 2? Into the corner boards now. Back and forth he goes, still holding on to the puck. Into the corner. Larson will pick it up, send that one all the way around. Lemieux gets across. Lemieux on a breakaway, and he's going to self-sauce it out of his reach. Unfortunate break there for Boily. As Sky was able to get back. Jager in the middle. On the back end, and he can't get that one to go. As a huge save from Markstrom.
Man, that closed the opponent away again. Does not go for Sky. He's done well on the draw so far, winning 11 against 7 to Boily.
That was a big break there for Boily. Now Makar behind the net on the breakout. Sky picks it up off the turnover. He scores! Lemieux is going to make it 5-4.
All right, all right, all right. He doesn't do it off that initial rush, but off the faceoff, able to set that one up, digs that out of the corner, had a man crashing back door. There you go. It's 5-4 in favor of Sky.
Big, big moment there for Sky now. Can he hold on to the lead? Into the zone now. Gets it down. Boily looking to wrap it immediately, and that one doesn't go. McKinnon now with it. Boily looking to tie it up again. Over to McDavid, he can't get it. McKinnon now walks out into the corner. Out in front, intercepted, and now under 3 to go. Sky trying to force a game 3. Still has the puck down behind the net. Curls back out in front. Shot on upstairs off the bar. Just narrowly missing that one. Now McKinnon out the other way. Is that down? And on the breakout, here goes Sky. Sky's got it. Sends it over to Couturier. Still has the puck. Looking to kill the final minute of game 2. He's got the 1-goal lead. Pinned up along the boards. Boily's got to go. He's running out of time. Sky looking to just kill the clock in the offensive zone back and forth. Boily's going to have to be aggressive here if he wants the puck back. And Sky content with just holding it in the offensive zone. Dahlin's got it. Couturier over to Jager. Jager sends that one back on the backhand. Pinned up along the boards, 25 seconds remaining. Over to Pasternak to Dahlin. Dahlin's got it. McKinnon now back into his offensive own zone, but Boily's gonna get there first, 13 seconds remaining. Can Boily tie it up? One more shot, the spin move to Pasternak, back over to huge save, 5 seconds remaining. And that'll do it for game number 2. Sky with some crazy nonsense at the end of that period, but he holds on.
What?
And we have got our first game save. 3 of the day.
Man, Boily looked like he was going to tie that up. What a game.
That was a great back and forth there. Boily getting up by 2. It looked like he was going to coast to a 2-0 win from the series. Sky battles back, scores 4 straight. Boily answers with 2 of his own. And with 3 minutes to go, we'll take a look at the replays here as it was 2-0 Boily, and then Sky spawned in. McDavid gets one, and then immediately off the draw, this was a huge momentum turner as Shen's going to send it to Kopitar. Lemieux got it, and he just fires it at the net. A weak wrister, I don't know, handcuffs his goalie. Now 2-2. Still in the second period, send it down to Matthews in a pretty passing play there. Finished off by Thompson. Now Crosby over to Forsberg. Walks out in front, Crosby towards the net. And again, they bang away at it, and he finally collects it to go upstairs, and he makes it 4-2. In the third now, a good answer back by Boily as he gets it off the rush. Moments later, it's now 4-3. And Tavares there for Boily over to Rantanen, and he collects that one as he just yells into his camera. But here it was, the turnover, Sky sends it across, and Lemieux with 4:30 remaining would get the game winner as Sky forces a game 3.
Yeah, again, he had to dig deep. He had to change up his play style. He certainly did that. He decided to match speed with speed rather than slowing the game down. But as the game went on, once he had the lead, he did get back to that possession where he could really start to chew some of that clock, and it helped him move on and force a game 3.
No, absolutely. And we've got a heck of a finish here as we look for our final representative joining Jose, Deli, and Cad in Washington. We'll be back with game number 3 right after this. As I think we're just going to stay. So, that being said, we'll wait for game 3. We're going to, I guess we got to address the hat. Just kidding, we don't have time. Game 3 is underway. All right, Boily versus Sky. Here we go, game 3. A shot at Washington on the line. Who's it going to be? And here we go. Sky's going to start with the puck off the draw. And we're going to get across the line. Sky looking to open up the scoring this time. On the backhand, still has it. Boily looking for... I mean, he had a great start, Grizz, in game number one, or game number two, so I'm not sure what he's got to do differently here.
Well, right there, it was already a great possession for Sky, but a good tie-up by Boily to get himself back underway, and he's going to have to continue to do that. And you got to find a way to score the first goal here, too.
Absolutely. I think for Sky, it's important because, you know, I don't think he wants to flirt with having to come back yet again. He definitely looked more comfortable in that third. He did blow that lead, but was able to stay composed enough to get it back late in the third period. As now into the zone. Back and forth he goes. As Boily looks to get one on the board here. That far side shot does not go. As now Nurse breaks the puck up. Over to Nurse. He looks to fire that one through. He does. Thompson quick passing to Matthews. Matthews now with it. Sends it down to Thompson. Back out to Draisaitl, and a great play there from Sky, and he is going to take a 1-0 lead.
Again, he's doing it a different way. He's not really relying on possession. He's just getting into the zone and throwing that one across, and Boily has not had an answer for these cross creases.
A great passing play there from Sky. Now we'll see if he's got another one in him as he's off to a great start in game 3. Larson now with it. Looks to break the puck up. As now across the line, it's McDavid behind the net. He waits to fire one in. Pressured there by Boily. Drives it wide back to Larson. Larson's got it, and that one's going to miss the net. And he breaks the puck up. Boily's got it on the backhand. Back to McDavid. Over to Lemieux. Lemieux has it now. Back and forth. Turns over. Over to Lemieux. Boily streaks into the zone. Still has it on the goal line. Over to McDavid. Boily's got it now. Turns over. Sky is taken, looking to break the puck out. As now Draisaitl has it over across the line. Now Bouwmeester down to Draisaitl, still has it. Couturier with it. Makar on the breakout to Jágr. Still has it on the backhand. Zubov to Bouwmeester. Back and forth across the line. Sky's got it. Grizz, what are you seeing out of Boily here?
Well, Boily's just unable to get the puck back, and much like last game, when Sky finally got the lead, that's when he really just started to use his possession skills to his advantage. So attack quick and then possess.
Now sends that one back. Still has the puck on the breakout. As Sky looking to not make any mistakes in this one as he cuts into the middle, looking for a second goal shot on. That one's going to be blocked. Good job there from Boily. Makar now back to Matthews. Boily's got it. He stops up, waits for some support, spins into the middle. Good read there from Sky as he tries to break the puck out cleanly. McKinnon now fires that one back to Jágr. Jágr to McKinnon. Over to Rantanen. Yossi's got it. Into the corner. Has it now on the backhand. Still has it. And Tavares with it. Now Nurse to Tavares. Over to Couturier, up to McKinnon. 1 minute to go. Boily off the turnover, 30 seconds remaining. He stops up, sends it across. And that one is going to be rimmed right around. as he spins far down. He's running out of time, sends it towards the front, and that one doesn't go. Sky is going to have a 1-0 lead going into period two.
All right, and again, he looked a lot like what we saw in game two once he was able to mount that comeback and go ahead by two. We're seeing him do that in a similar fashion here. He's done a good job to contain Boily as well. Boily just not able to really strip Sky of the puck once he has the puck. Great possession opportunities here for Sky early. So now it's Boily's chance. He needs to adapt as well.
Pinned up along the board. Sky looking to get a 2-0 lead off the turnover. Here's Jágr behind the net. That one's going to be knocked free. MacKinnon with it. He speeds in. Boily's got a step and can't get that one off. Still has the puck with MacKinnon turned over. Sky with it. Rims that one around on the breakout. Sauces that one up to Couturier. Over to Jágr. Over to Schenn now. Couturier with it at the point. MacKinnon now with it. Into the corner. Now down to Jágr. Jager's got it. Still has it. Back to Nurse. Over to Schenn. Schenn now with it. Back to Nurse. Over to the point now is Schenn. Schenn has been all over the ice for Sky in this series, Grizz.
Yeah, every zone, he's really hammering him away. Maybe not who you'd expect to make their mark on this game, but Sky, hey, whatever player's out there, he's been getting it done. He leads it 1-0 as Boily gets the cover there. And man, Boily, we have not really seen that much offensive zone chances from him. And it's because, again, he can't get the puck away from Sky. Sky is just chalking up all of this time on attack, maintaining possession of the puck and not giving it back.
Tied up along the faceoff dot. Lemieux on the breakout to Meyer. As Schenn moving on to the second round for his Toronto Maple Leafs, as Boily is narrowly going to miss that one. Sky into the corner, comes away free. Lemieux's not going to get that one as he just misses that. Over to Kopitar. Kopitar with it. Waits for pressure, still has it. Back out in front, Lemieux is gonna bury that one. It is 2-0.
Oh, nice crafty move, using the thumbs to his advantage there to open up that passing lane across. And once again, Sky hammering home those cross crease passes.
That's a great puck movement now. And the nerves have got a shift to Boily as he needs one as he finds himself down by two yet again in game number three. Jágr with it across the line. He's poke free. Sky back on the breakout. Hits Matthews. Sends that one to Larson. Larson now with it. Thompson's got it. On the backhand. Sends that back to Josi. Josi with it. Sends it back down to Draisaitl. Over to Matthews. Tries to walk out in front. He can't. And he's pressured there by Boily. Pasternak now. It's across the line. Jágr now back out to Pasternak, and he can't get it to go. Boily looking for something, now trailing by two. It's now a spin move out in front, and there it is! Boily is going to get on the board as a great spin move in the corner makes it a 2-1 game.
And again, Boily's vision next level, takes that one in behind the net, works it back out in front. Open man crash in the net, knocks that one in, and Gritty was hanging out in the area on the boards. He didn't like that one for his club.
Big moment now for Sky. Again, they've been trading two goal leads as they don't want to hold on to it, it appears. And that's going to be a power play as now Boily's got a great chance to tie things up.
Here we go. And it's momentum swings. We've talked about it all day, all season. When you get that first goal back, things start to change.
Meyer over to Lemieux. He can't get the shot away. And now Couturier shorthanded for Sky. It's going to be knocked free. As Dahlin now on the breakout. Here goes Meyer. Meyer with it now. Boily looking to tie things up, and he misses that one. Still has it. Lemieux walks out in front. That one doesn't go. Gretzky fires it at the net. And Sky is going to hold on to that one.
Yeah, now Sky, man, he's got his back up against the wall a little bit as Boily starting to get some of that time on attack back, and he's starting to get very comfortable, and he's going for an aggressive faceoff look.
Tie up off the draw. Now Darlene ready to send it around. Maybe a wrap, doesn't get it. Behind the net, tries to walk it out in front. Still has the puck, as now Holik's got it. Holik in the corner. That one's gonna be knocked aside. Shen with it now. Sends that one to Dreisaitl. Dreisaitl now. Sends that one over to MacKinnon. MacKinnon now over to Krupp. He's got it to Holik. Nice little give and go. Power play's over. The Sky looking to hold on late in the second period. Can't clear that one out. Behind the net. Now MacKinnon. MacKinnon can't get it through. And now McDavid looks to try and get one through. He can't. MacKinnon now with it to Nurse. At the point, sends it back around. Is Sky looking to hold on to the lead here? And we've got one final minute, Grizz. We'll see if he can hold on to the lead.
Yeah, here we go in the second period. But here comes Sky as he's looking for that third goal. Doesn't look like he's gonna get it as he will remain a 1-0 lead. Looking for that last check in, last second shot didn't go. But a 2-1 lead going into the locker room. One more period to go before we decide our final contestant that we will see live in DC.
Absolutely wild scenes there as we have got a intense finish in the third period as Sky has got a one goal lead, a narrow one goal lead. And we'll see if he can hold on to it. And Boily now off the breakout. Here's MacKinnon. MacKinnon now across the line, still has the puck into the corner. Back out in front, and that one doesn't go. Looks to break it up to Couturier. Sends that one. Boily's got it. And now Couturier sends that to McDavid. McDavid pinned up along the boards. Over to MacKinnon. To Darlene. McDavid now with it. Across the line. He's in tight and he can't get that one to go. Now Darlene rifles that one at the net. Jen's got it. Can't get it through. Back out to McDavid and he scores! And it is all tied up at two.
Man, this series, we knew we were gonna get something special with this series. It's definitely delivered with these lead changes, blown leads as well. Boily did take game one pretty handedly, but game two blew the 2-0 lead to force the game three. And now Sky, the 2-0 lead vanished.
Curls back along the goal line. Can Sky get the lead back once again? As it appears that they don't want to lose as opposed to trying to win, as they just can't hang on to leads. As now Yossi's got it. It leads to some great entertainment, though, as now Boily's got a step. He's in all alone, and again for the second straight breakaway from Boily. He self-sauces it too far, and it costs him dearly. Now McDavid out the other way. Still has the puck, and that one is going to be offside.
Man, had the chance to take the lead there and goes for the self-sauce. Too far away. Blows his chance on the B-way, but still tied. Game still up for grabs here.
Now Couturier's got it. Darlene now with it. Across the line, can Boily get one back here? Pasternak looking for the go-ahead goal late in the third. Now to Couturier. Couturier back and forth. Over to Jágr, over to MacKinnon now. Back over to Couturier, breaks the puck out. Intercepted there. Boily calms things down. As what a finish we've got in our last semifinal of the North American Console Championships. And now into the corner. Sends that one back out. Dreisaitl hits Matthews in stride. Curls into the middle. He's got a step, but a good poke check there. Grizz, you thinking overtime here or what?
No, I think one of these guys is going to pull away here very shortly.
As Rantanen now down behind the net. Boily's got it. Back out in front. That one's going to be stopped as Omar goes, throws it in his net.
And that was close. Very weird play there, as he did go for that post play, was covered well, but then a bounce and Omar had to reach back and get the stop.
Threw that right into his own net almost. 2-2 game. Dahlin with it off the faceoff. Back in front, he scores! Boyle makes it 3-2 and terrifies the audience.
Oh, man, I love that. He is such an emotional player. Every year we see that out of him. He knows what that goal means. But now you still got to play defense because Sky has looked good offensively as well. 7-10 to go. Uses McDavid to get the lead.
A lead in this series has meant very, very little, as now Sky down by one with 6 minutes to go. Gets into the zone. Spins around. Jágr doesn't shoot. Thought he might have had some space there, pinned up along the boards. Now back to Couturier. Couturier's got it. Over to McKinnon. McKinnon spins back around. Couturier with it. Still holds onto the puck. Boyle has it. McKinnon now. Over to Couturier. And now McKinnon. 4 minutes to go. Not sure what he was waiting for there. Be all the way back into his own zone now on the breakout. Turned over on the breakout. Here's Boyle looking to finish it. Back to Gretzky and he can't bury it. Pinned up along the boards. Now Lemieux back to power. Sends that one across. Good read. Spins back around now to Makar. Now all the way around. Here's McDavid. And power on the intercept. He's going to break that one out. Over to Nurse. Lemieux has it, still on the blue line, walks it in. Can he get it? A huge save there. McDavid robbed under a minute to go. Lemieux with the puck. Sky needs one now. Over to McDavid, behind the net. Can Boyle hold on to the lead? Back and forth he goes. Still has it, walks out in front. It doesn't go. Markstrom is gonna hold on to that one. And it's still 3-2 Boyle.
Not for lack of effort. Sky is making his final push, his final plea to tie this game up. And man, he is left without that game tying goal. Looks like we will get our timeouts as he's going for the aggressive faceoff as well.
Here we go, 41 seconds to go. Sky down by one. Off the draw, McKinnon, he scores! He gets that one to go, executed perfectly. And it's 3-3.
There we go. The faceoff play pays off, and it's not the first time we've seen that out of Sky either. And there it is, Nathan McKinnon off the draw, let it rip. And we are tied with 39 seconds to go in the third.
What a finish here. Will we get to overtime? And Boyle off the turnover, walks in. McDavid with it, 30 seconds to go. Sky sends it over to McKinnon. Trying to end it before overtime. Jágr now into the corner with pressure there. Sky rotates around to McKinnon. Pressured. Jágr picks it up. 15 seconds to go. Nurse walks in. Still has the puck. Back to Jágr and he can't score. He misses the net. McKinnon with it. Over to Couturier. 6 seconds remaining. Now to Jágr. Still has the puck. Curls back in front. Shut up with 0.5 to go. And Sky is going to take the lead and the series.
Oh, no. You felt like it was, oh, my goodness. What a play. What a possession by Sky. And again, McKinnon on that post play that we've seen him try to do tonight. That
with
was incredible.
5 seconds remaining. Sky is taken, is able to get one, avoids overtime, and he comes back in the final minutes. Unbelievable poise to book his ticket to DC. What a finish there, Grizz.
Tied it with 39 seconds left. Scored the game winner with under a second left. That is poise. That is mental fortitude. We will see you in DC.
I thought for sure that the Jágr miss was going to be it. Because I don't know how he missed the far side there with Jágr, but we're going to find out in just a second. As I think he's got to calm down a little bit. The vibes are high. The nerves are gone. Sky, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Man, obviously the biggest win, I think, for you in playing competitive NHL. How did that final minute feel to finally win that one?
I cannot believe my Jager missed the wide open net, and then I had the rebound too, and I hit the post, and then I just went behind the net and saw, I don't even know who it was, and I don't even know how much time was on the clock left, so I don't know.
So it all started in game two. You're down 2-0. What was going through your mind? Boily was taking control of the game. You knew that it was now or never. What did you do to switch it up and take that game to force game three?
I started being more aggressive. And then when I got the lead, I tried to slow things down a little bit to get them frustrated. So it worked out.
I gotta say that, yeah, when that Jager missed, just by how the series went, where both of you were just trading, no one would pull away, it seemed. When that Jager missed, it really felt like, oh my gosh, like I think Boily is now gonna come down and score. Yeah, like what's going through your head there in that instance?
Honestly, I don't know. I just had to stick with it. I really could not stop him behind the net. I don't even know what his defense has gotten so much better since the last time we played. So it was, he's the hardest opponent I've ever played all year. So.
Oh man, congratulations. We will see you in DC on May 20th. Congrats again. It's been fun to watch your competitive career now in NHL, capped off with a shot at the North American Finals in Washington. So congrats again. We're going to bring on Boily and, this can't be fun. All right, brother, in the last minute, what happened there? Walk us through in the last minute.
I don't know. I knew he was doing the play at the face, so I tried to pull the chin and score, and at the end, scored with 0.5 seconds. Congrats to this guy. It was good games. Was a little bit delayed on spiking at 100 MS and shit. It's all good. It's the game. And hoping him the best and with the best for the four finalists in Washington, Stoughton, but the game will learn. I'm still young and yeah, I'm learning that stuff.
So Sky said that you were the toughest opponent that he's played against all year. What do you think you have to do to get further in this tournament next year?
Don't choke. I choke. Was up by one in the minutes there. I learned.
You had a great run, my man. Tough finish there, but I feel like this will not be the last time we see you in the NHL World Championship. So again, great series, and excited to see you back next year. Grizz, all right, let's take a look at the bracket as now it is all said and done. All right, we have our four finalists that are going to play out for the North American Console Finals. It is Cad and Sky is taken. They booked their ticket to Washington, joining DunkinDeli and Jose. And I asked them, I tried to stir the pot a little bit, but I'm going to ask you, who do you think is the favorite going into that event?
I'm going to go with Jose. I think Jose has the experience necessary, and he's really shored up his game a lot. We saw that again in the Chell Challenge last year, taking down Eki. And I think he's proved that he can compete with the best. I think he has the best chance to get it done.
We'll find out. Let's take a look at the replays, because we had a heck of a game there. And Sky able to get up 2-0 in the second, though. That's when Boily started to go to work. As he was in behind the net, came right back out in front, and a great passing play there as Couturier made it 2-1. And this is kind of the exact same thing that happened in the prior game, a 2-goal lead for Sky, and that evaporated. Early in the third, Boily is able to get that behind the net play. McDavid with close quarters, and Boily is fired up because he knows momentum swung his way. 7 minutes to go in the third. A pass across off the faceoff, and Boily thinks, hey, that might be it. But 41 seconds to go. Off the faceoff play, McKinnon buries it. 40 seconds to go. And then with 10 seconds remaining, a shot misses that Sky is just bewildered by. He kicks it around. He's got under 5 to go. Spins free and is able, with 0.5 seconds remaining, to bury home that far side post play. And you see the reaction. He is fired up that he is able to make it to the next stage of the tournament. That being said, let's talk about that next stage of the tournament, Grizz. The NA Finals. We are going to see the four players that we saw this weekend advance. That will be live from District E in Washington, D.C. on May 20th, 1 p.m. Eastern time. Available to watch for everyone on twitch.tv/NHL or on YouTube, youtube.com/NHL. So excited to see how that one plays out. We are going to get these four competitors on stage. Yes, DunkinDeli will be there yelling at everyone. You got to tune in. It is going to be an absolute blast. But we've got some traveling to do of our own because next week, May 6th, the Europeans are going to take center stage. That means Eki, he's back in Gothenburg, Sweden on May 6th at 1 p.m. Eastern time. Again, right here on twitch.tv/NHL, youtube.com/NHL. Grizz, we are going to be back for the live European finals and the two European winners of each of those series, the two semifinals, they will not only have their shot to be the European champion, they will also book their ticket to the world finals later in the summer, and they will take on the two North American finalists that will compete again in Washington. So the tournament is not over. We've got tons of action left. I'm super excited to see how this is all going to play out. I want to thank everyone for watching. Grizz, any final thoughts?
I just can't wait, man. We have three big tournaments coming up now live. The online play is done. Now it is, how do you play under the bright lights? We know that John Wayne says everything's different under the bright lights. Who is going to carve out their piece in NHL esports history this season? Ready to get after it.
I can't wait. So for myself, Grizz, and everyone from production, I'm excited. Can't wait to get after the finals in Europe next week. Thank you guys again for watching, and we'll see you next time. Have a good one. Thank you.